What's up, y'all? It's your boy T-Thizzle88. It's just T-Thizzle saying hi to the Sizzles. He is getting ready to bring y'all yes or no a Modern Warfare 2 throwback gameplay. Are you kidding me? Now, right now, this isn't looking like Modern Warfare 2. This is looking more of Advanced Titanfall right now, because I'm guessing this is what the exosuits and all that stuff is going to be like. That's why I had to mix it up and give you all the title Advanced Titanfall, because you got the jumping that's getting ready going. Look at this dude right here. And look at me with that clutch aim. Like, I feel if you're able to master the craft of this type of stuff, the modded lobbies that go on in Modern Warfare 2, then you're going to be set for Advanced Warfare, because you got the exosuits, and hopefully you're not going to be jumping this high. But if you do happen to be jumping this high in Advanced Warfare, and you've already mastered it on Modern Warfare 2, or whatever this game is, I don't even know what it is anymore, I feel like you're going to be put in an awesome position for having the aim and having the abilities to be able to maneuver the maps and stuff like that in Titan. I almost said Titanfall. I meant Advanced Warfare. Now, I actually didn't hop on Modern Warfare 2 to find modded lobbies, but I just so happened to get in a match where one basically got landed in one of these lobbies, and I said, why not? Why not go ahead and turn on the Elgato and see what I can do, and maybe this will actually play into a good commentary. So, anyway, that's besides the fact. What I'm really here to talk to y'all about is another episode of Storytime. This one is an interesting story from one of my old jobs. I used to work at a restaurant as a waitress, and there goes the reset. Yeah, the modders, yeah, they have complete control. I guess he saw that I was beasting and feasting too much in this one. You can literally see, before he restarted this match, I was on the top of the leaderboard in their own game. If you're a modder, I personally feel that you're supposed to be on top, and you're supposed to be showing everybody else out. Don't be a modder and then get done up in your own modded lobby. At least you're the one who has all the control over the scores, the different game styles, god mode, and stuff like that. If you're gonna mod, at least win in the modded lobbies. So he saw that I was beasting on him too much. He just reset the lobby and I continue to beast. But anyway, like I said, at my old job, I used to be a waiter and basically delivering food, cleaning tables, putting the dishes back in the dish area, even working cash register, because this wasn't a traditional restaurant. At this restaurant, you actually was basically in a self-serve. So although a waiter or a waitress delivered the food, you still got your own drinks, you still got your condiments, you still paid at a register like any other fast food restaurant. So this was kind of half fast food restaurant-y, but at the same time, still of a restaurant. It was in a nice location and everything like that. So, at my job, we all had fun. It was consisted mainly of dudes at the time of this story, and we had a lot of crazy employees there. Crazy as in literally crazy as in just fun crazy, and any other type of crazy you can think of. So, my friend, he was about older, mid-20s or so. We were playing around, and the way it was set up, the counter in the back where you prepare the food had a little spot that the customers can actually see you from behind. And normally, the counter is supposed to be guarded so customers aren't seeing anything you're doing, anything preparing with the food or anything like that. But this part of the counter basically had a blind spot where the customers could actually see where they're sitting at the table. So we were just playing around and everything like that. And my coworker, he challenged me to an arm wrestle match because I'm pretty buff. I'm a pretty big dude, I would say. And he actually challenged me because he felt that he could handle me. At the time, I had braids. I was the only black dude there. They all called me Snoop Dogg. One called me Snoop Dogg, and after that, it was basically like a virus. Everybody just started calling me it. And so he challenged me to an arm wrestling match. At this time, there wasn't that many customers inside, so we actually decided to go to the front counter where the actual customers were. And he got on one side of the counter, I got on the other side, and he challenged me, and I ended up beating him. So after I beat him, some lady, I would say she's pretty young. She looked pretty good. She was looked like she just got done working out. She had the tights on and everything. And I guess she saw us arm wrestling. And after she saw me beat my coworker, she challenged me. And then she was like, oh, you think you're strong, huh? So she was basically taunting at me and everything. And I was like, yeah, it's nothing. And she was like, too bad you can't beat me. I was like, well, let's go. So then at this point, she challenges me and I pretend that I'm weak and everything. I let her beat me. And then, so at this point, I'm feeling into her and everything. And I decide to try to get her number while I'm on the clock. So I try to get her number. She gets ready to head out. And I say, hey, can I think you seem like a pretty cool person. I'd like to get to know you outside of this. Maybe if we could exchange numbers or something like that. She hit me with a business card. I found out she was a yoga instructor. And so that ended kind of bad. Not what I expected. I was actually considering going to her yoga classes, but I was like, oh, no, forget it. I found out she had a husband and everything. So that sucked. This has been Boy Teethizzle 88. Peace out with the modded lobby.